Valley of Ashes is not a developed country, a developed state. It is full of desert. There are only three places over there: a gas station, which is owned by George Wilson, a garage, which is owned by him, and a restaurant. We are given the picture that the Valley of Ashes is comparatively a low, or we can say there the people are of middle class or lower class. And from West Tech and East Tech, the people are from upper class. Here, Tom invites Nick in this second chapter that he should come accompany him for New York and meet his mistress. So Tom is taking credit, or he is feeling proud that he has a mistress, and he wants Nick to meet his mistress, so he takes Nick with him. And throughout the second chapter, we are given the picture that Tom takes Nick with him, and then they go to the garage, because the garage comes in the middle of East Egg and New York. There they take a halt for gas filling of the car, and then they talk to, we are given the introduction of Wilson's character, George Wilson, who is husband of Martel Wilson. And Martel Wilson has an affair, or is mistress of Tom Buchanan. So Tom wants to tell Martel that he is going to New York, and that's why she should also come over there. See, Tom is taking credit, or he is feeling proud that he has a mistress, but he is not ready to accompany her with them in his own car. So he tells her that she should come in train, and then they meet at New York. Now, through this, the character of Nick is highlighted that Nick is a silent observer. As his the advice of his father has given to him, that you are supposed to observe the people and don't give your judgment suddenly or initially. First observe and then give your judgment. So here he is observing that Tom is taking pride that he has a mistress, but he does not want to accompany her through the travel to New York. Now, when they reach New York, the another surprise or shock we can say for Nick is that Tom has already have an rented apartment over there, where continuously he comes with Martel, enjoys parties, have fun, and then goes back. The hollowness of the characters, the hollowness of American dream is highlighted here in the character of Tom himself. Still, Nick does not say anything. He is observing. The apartment is a very beautiful place. It is loaded with furniture. The furniture in comparison to the apartment is quite huge. Means the places is filled with furniture. There we have the characteristics of two characters. First, Tom, which we have discussed, and second, Martel Wilson, who is already married to George Wilson, but she has her own desire and dream, so she falls a prey for Tom and has an affair with him. And then when she gets whatever she wants, that is a huge apartment, a beautiful furniture, she tries to complete her dream through this affair with Tom Buchanan. But after they arrive over there, there is a party thrown by Tom, where the neighbors are invited. Mr. and Mrs. McKay is invited for the party. Even Martel's sister Catherine is invited for the party. And when the party takes place, what happens is that initially the American party is full of food, laughter, and drinks. So here also they drink a lot and no one knows what is going on around. But the party breaks in early morning when there is a fight between Martel and Tom. What is the fight about? Martel wants to say the name of Daisy. Daisy is Tom's wife. Tom does not want to listen the name, and that's why he hits Martel and breaks her nose. Now here we are given the character of Tom. Definitely, Tom is not feeling guilty that he is having an affair outside his marriage. That's why he hits Martel. But he does not want to listen the name of his wife while he is enjoying his life over here. Alright? So there is no sense of guilt in Tom right now. The party gets over and we see that Nick goes back home observing again. We have the third chapter where Nick describes guest-based fantastic parties, because now Nick has already attended 2 to 3 parties of Gatsby, where he gets the invitation and he goes to the party. What is the party about? that young men and women enjoy their life at the end of every weekend. So we get a picture that Gatsby is a millionaire or a billionaire who arranges parties every weekend. But the reason is not given to anyone. People come and go. The peculiarity of the party is that anyone can attend the party. There is no need for an invitation for the party. Everyone is invited. Anyone can come and anyone can go. So Nick is surprised when he is given the invitation for the party. He comes to the party, enjoys the party. But as we all know, if you go to a party alone, you feel bored. So Nick also starts feeling bored because he came to the party to meet Jay. And Jay is not there. So he's searching for Jay. At last, he cannot find Jay, but definitely finds Jordan. And he acquaints himself with her. And then at last he could enjoy the party. Now, the next time when the party is reaching its end, we see that Nick and Jordan are searching for Gatsby. And when they get tired of searching him, they cannot find him throughout the party. And then at the end, when they get tired and they sit near a table, they realize that the person sitting next to them is none other but Jay Gatsby himself. When Nick complains that how come this party is all about when the host is not present in the party. And then Gatsby turns towards Nick and tells him that what is your problem? What are you facing over here? What problem you are facing over here? And then we have the discussion between Nick and Gatsby. Then when Nick realizes that he is talking to Gatsby, there is an illusion in the mind of Nick, as we always have. When you don't meet anyone, you know you take your own assumption that this person would be like this or like that. But here, when Nick meets Gatsby, he has his own assumption about him, that Gatsby would be a gray-haired old man because he's such a rich person. But when he looks at Gatsby, he is surprised that a young man in his late 30s, alright, and quite handsome in his appearance and very polite in his manner. So Nick gets charmed towards the character of Gatsby. So his illusion is broken that Gatsby would be an old man who would be very rude and very proud about himself. Now he thinks that no, Gatsby is a young man, alright, and now he starts thinking that how come a young man at the age of 30 could be such a rich man? Either he would be born rich or he might have done something wrong in his life. This is not only the assumption of Nick, but it is the assumption of everyone who is attending Jay's party. No one knows the real past of Jay's life. Slowly and gradually, when the novel develops, we will see that Nick becomes a very good friend of Jay, and then we will get the past of Jay's life. After this meeting, Jay Gatsby leaves the party and he goes to attend a phone call. And then he invites Jordan. He wants to talk to Jordan. And Nick realizes that it is getting late and he is all alone, so he should leave. Nick leaves the party. In the next book, that is book 4, we are given the picture that Nick is invited again by Gatsby for lunch. Nick and Gatsby goes for lunch to New York in his beautiful, magnificent car. The car is a very good picture. Again, color is being used over here because the car color is yellow color. Yellow color, if we see, is the color of gold, and gold means richness, prosperity. So here also his car is a Rolls-Royce, yellow color Rolls-Royce, and very peculiar and famous in the whole place. Why? Because no one else has such a beautiful car. So Nick observes the car from outside, and then he is happy that he gets a chance to observe the car within, because he is going to accompany Jay in the car. He accompanies Jay in his car, and then they take the route to New York. While they are going, we get the picture that Jay informs Nick about his past life. Now see, Jay is very profound. He knows what he wants in his life. So what does he do? He talks to Nick and he gives him evidence that he is telling him about his past. Till now, Nick has listened or observed from number of people who knew Gatsby and who did not know him, that Gatsby is someone who was born rich, means traditionally a rich man, or someone who had attained richness by doing crime, basically bootlegging, means selling liquor or buying liquor, because it was time after First World War when America banned liquor in the state. So people think that this were the two ways, either he was born rich or he has done something wrong in his life. So here Gatsby thinks that he should tell Nick that he has neither attained his money from his traditional way or ancestral way, nor he has committed crime. So he proves evidence one by one that he has completed his education from Oxford. He comes out with a picture. He has also been playing a part in the military army during the First World War. He also gives him evidence for that. And in a way, when they reach New York, Nick is convinced that Jay Gatsby was born rich. He was born by the birth rich, and he has not committed any crime in his life. Now, this is half truth of Jay, which he informs it to Nick. When he reaches over there, we see that Jay makes Nick meet his one and only one friend, that is Meyer. Now, if we see the character of Meyer is a gangster by profession, and Nick has, when he meets Meyer, he realizes that Meyer is a Jewish person by origin, and Meyer takes the credit that he has created Gatsby who he is right now. So now again Nick is confused whether to trust Gatsby or to trust Meyer. He lives there only. Why? Because his father had told him, don't judge anyone quickly. So he's not taking any decision right now. He is just observing, that let me observe more about this person. And then when he meets over there, they have their lunch again. Nick and Jay returns back, and after that we have the another chapter where the story of Jay and Nick continues, and Nick attends a number of other parties given by Jay. This time we know that Jay wants Nick to invite Daisy over his house. Why? Because Jay informs Nick that he was in love with Daisy, in a way is in love with Daisy still, and Daisy is his lifelong dream. All right, this dream of Jay is the American dream, which at the end we will discuss the comparison between the two. So Daisy is the love of Gatsby and Nick is the cousin of Daisy. So now everything is cleared in the mind of Nick, that why Gatsby invited him for his parties, why Gatsby befriended him, and what kind of favor Gatsby wants from Nick. So Nick says that, all right, if you want me to arrange a meeting between the two, I'll help you. And after so many problems and so many things, we see that at last Nick is capable of arranging a meeting between Jay and Daisy at the household of Jay himself. The meeting takes place after 5 years. There is a 5 years gap between their love. Now, when Daisy looks at Jay, she thinks that she is a bit nervous. All right, it's a shock for her because she has not expected Jay to be present over here. But after a particular period of time, they both talk with each other. Nick leave them alone and they both talk with each other, and after their conversation goes further, they feel comfortable in each other's company and their old love is reunioned again. Nick realizes the fact. Jay wants Daisy to observe a look at the mansion he has created, and then Jay takes them both, Nick and Daisy, to his household. That's a big huge mansion in the East Eggs. And we see that Daisy is surprised. She is happy that Jay has a beautiful household, such a huge mansion, such a beautiful garden, such a huge porch, and she is happy. She observes everything, and Jay shows her each and every corner of his house. When Jay takes them to his own room, his room is quite simple in appearance than the other rooms in the mansion. It has a simple bed. It has a huge picture of a person called Dan Cody, a man who has helped Jay. And when Jay is going to talk to Nick We'll come to know that what happened, how Jay became rich in the last part of the novel. Now, then Jay invites Daisy and her husband for one of his parties. He arranges very well for the party and the invitation is given to everyone. Everyone arrives at the party. This party is going to be a very significant party in the novel. Why? Because the party is thrown by an East Egg person and it is going to be observed by the eyes of a West Egg person. Right? West Egg, definitely Daisy, Tom, Jordan. East Egg, that is of course our Jay Gatsby and Nick. Tom, Jay is very much confused that how Daisy will react to the party. When Daisy, Tom and Jordan arrive at the party, Daisy is surprised, shocked. Why? Because she thinks that it is a over show which is done by Jay, because he has become rich nowadays, means recently he is a rich person, so he's showing off to the world that how much money he has and how lavishly he can spend his money. And the other thing is that she thinks that it is a vulgar party. Why? Because everyone is behaving according to their own terms and condition. No one is concerned about the other person. The only thing that Daisy likes about the party is that a beautiful actress is being invited in the party and she and her director is sitting in the corner of the garden on a table. She observes that and she thinks that this is portion of the party is only the beautiful part of the party. Otherwise, it's a show done by Jay. Jay realizes that Daisy is not happy with the party and he starts talking to Nick or asking question about it to Nick that Daisy is not happy with the party and Tom and Daisy leaves. When Tom and Daisy leaves, we see that Tom invites Jay to his household for a dinner. The invitation is given. Meanwhile, Nick and Jay talks with each other. Then Jay informs Nick that when he was 17, he left his household. He had traveled for 5 years, right? And when he was 17, he left his household. Why he left his household? Because he was a son of a farmer, and that also an unsuccessful farmer. And his original name was James Getz.